Today we're going to talk about HDR. HDR stands for High Dynamic Range. Basically, the camera can see about 4 to 6 f-stops in range of tone. You notice here there's no detail in the sky. In this exposure that's overexposed, I have detail in the shadow area. When I look at the underexposed photograph, this is 2 stops down, it's completely blacked out, but I have detail in the sky. So since your eye can see 10 or 11 f-stops, the camera can't. So HDR allows you to compress those tones together so it can see the way your eye sees the photograph. Step 1. Select the photographs that you have in your exposure. Could be 3, 6, 9, as many as you'd like. You want to make sure that you at least have the exposures that hold onto the detail in the shadows while capturing also the detail in the highlights. Tools, Photoshop, Merged HDR Pro. That's going to take us into the Camera Raw dialog box after it's stacked up these photographs into perfect alignment. It also goes through the lens database and adjusts for and corrects any distortion caused by the lens that you use. And then it aligns those photographs and presents you with the Camera Raw dialog box. In this dialog box, you have a bunch of choices. You have some presets that are already made for you. Certainly try those out. Photorealistic high contrast and low contrast are pretty good places to start. My favorite way is to basically come into to the detail area, push that up until I see nice crunchy detail contrast in the photograph. Adjust the radius just slightly so I get some nice brilliant colors popping out. A little bit on the strength. Usually the radius I want to have a little bit more than the strength so I don't get any halos around the outside edge. But do be careful with radius. It can cause all kinds of extra issues. I might want to bring down my shadows to make them a little bit darker, but still retain detail. Or I may want to make my highlights even a little bit darker. Gamma adjusts the compression rate between the highlights and the shadows. Going to the right, pushes them together. Going to the left, pulls them apart. So right in the center, we've got both the detail in the highlights and in the shadows. Vibrance, you could do this to taste. Keep it a little bit on the light side if you want photorealistic colors, and you can go all the way up with it if you'd like to really get a saturated color palette. Saturation, the same thing. If you want that overprocessed look that HDR is really famous for, or infamous for, then you would leave the saturation high. My preference is to make it still look like a photograph when I'm all done. I simply hit OK. And then the HDR program will go to work compositing those 3 photographs together, aligning them, correcting for any distortions, and there's my final image. Beautiful, huh? Now if we notice, we can see the detail both in the highlights of the image, and if I push down to the bottom of the photograph, we can even see the detail in the bus, which was in deep dark shadow. There's not much noise because I've actually taken 3 photographs together and merged them, so there was a proper exposure for the shadow area. Notice also, since some people were moving in the scene, they'll be appearing as blurred objects, or maybe a ghost here or there. That could be kind of fun. Thanks.